Hare Krishna. Oh, we are on a spiritual journey for the Kolkata Dham. We will go to the various spiritual places in Kolkata city. We are on a drive with Sachinandan Prabhu, Abhiram Prabhu, Sudama Prabhu, Sri Ram Prabhu and me. We will first go to the Bagh Bazar Gaudi Math, and then we will, where the Bhakti Sansari Thakur left his body, then we will go to the Iskon temple and see the Radha Govinda, have prasadam there, and after that we can go to the Scottish Church College where Prabhupada is education, Mufti Lal School where Prabhupada is schooling, and after that we will go to the place where the Prabhupada meets his spiritual master first time and inspired him to have the preach all over the world. That was a special place. And Prabhupada's birthplace also, and Prabhupada's favorite deity Radha Govinda is old, which Prabhupada worship. That's all. This is our whole program of visiting the Kolkata Dham city. Hare Krishna. And we are slowly moving toward the Prabhupada birthplace, and we all devotees are here, and actually there is a confusion that which jackfruit tree is original. So here there is a two jackfruit tree, and Iskon have occupied the both jackfruit tree places, and it is and we have reached there almost. This is the written here, under this same divine jackfruit tree, His Divine Grace A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Sri Prabhupada, the founder Acharya of ISKCON, was born on Tuesday, 1st September 1896, at about 355, Mithun Lagna. Generally, the lifespan of jackfruit tree is 100 to 150 years, and this tree is over 125 years old. Pilgrims are requested to not harm this divine tree in any manner. Do not pluck trees or bark from this tree. Hare Krishna. We have almost reached there. This is the original tree.
Jackfruit.
This is Prabhupada's birthplace. Under this tree he was born. And you've shown this tree. Tree is over 125 years old. Look, this is a nice jackfruit. Look at that small one. Kochi jackfruit. Yeah, this is the jackfruit tree which they say first that Prabhupada was born in this tree. So we saw the other tree which they claim now is the original tree. But they also say that this was the tree which was there. So both actually belong to ISKCON. But hopefully, as per what everybody says, is that is the tree which we saw first, is the original tree under which Prabhupada was born. But there's another source also that this could be the tree. So then I'll have darshan. And this temple is of Prabhupada time, and where Prabhupada worship, and we can see it's 250 years old temple, and we can see the Radha Madan Mohan deity, and the secret is that by
going to the right hand corner of this temple, we can see the Radha Govind deity, which Prabhupada going to see, and it's very old deity, very nice, beautiful deity here. And this is a very old temple here, and here Prabhupada visit. This is holy place and very nice temple, old architecture. Oh, we have just seen the birthplace of Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki! Now we are moving ahead for the ISKCON temple, ISKCON Kolkata. We will see, have the darshan of the Sri Radha Govinda and Sri Jagannath Baladev Subhadravai ki. So we are in the traffic, and the birthplace is very nice. Srila Prabhupada's birthplace is very, very nice, very ancient. And we have seen the darshan of Sri Radha Madan Mohan and Sri Radha Govinda, both. So this is a secret. You should have the darshan of both the deities. Hare Krishna. On Kolkata Dham ki. This is the monument made by Russian devotees, and this is the 50th anniversary celebration. And we are presently in the ISKCON Kolkata, Sri Radha Govinda Temple, and we are going to see the Prabhupada's room upstairs. Haribo. Let's go. So we reached upstairs, and this is the main entrance of the temple hall, and these Jai Vijay deities here, and they are Vaikuntha guards, so we have to take permission from him to get inside. Hare Krishna. And then actually we reached here late, it's due to traffic, heavy traffic, and my temple is closed, our bad luck. And this is the temple hall. Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada is there. Very nice temple hall. Srila Prabhupada ki. We are in the temple hall, and behind me there is a Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada's personal room. When Prabhupada come to Kolkata, Prabhupada stay here in this room and also personally receive all the guests in this room. So let's go inside. Now here you can see the personal bed of Srila Prabhupada, which Srila Prabhupada stay here and rest here. And also this we have some this sitting place for the guest, where Prabhupada receive all the guest VIPs here. And this is the personal sitting place of Guru Srila Prabhupada. When he come in Kolkata, he usually stays in the temple here. And this is also the backside of toilet here. This personal room, refresh room is there. And this is the sitting bed in which the Prabhupada take rest, and Prabhupada's personal room. Very nice room this. And this is the personal toilet of Srila Prabhupada. And Prabhupada used it during this stay in Kolkata. Hare Krishna. Everything is nicely maintained here. It's around more than 50 years of ISKCON, and it is very nicely maintained here. Everything, daily service is given to this room, and special care is taken for this personal room of Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna, we have been to the famous Putiram shop where Prabhupada used to have famous kachoris at his time. When he used to go to the presidency college, then he used to come to Putiram shop and eat kachori there. Prabhupada also knows as kachori mukha. Prabhupada used to eat kachori there. We see that shop, small shop, famous. Radha Govind temple at which Prabhupada used to visit here. And have daily darshan in the temple. So let's go inside. This is the entrance, and this is a very old temple, and this is maintained by the Malik Parivar, and Prabhupada used to stay here also. And this is the very famous temple, and deity is very beautiful, and we have darshan here, and here also one Gaur Nitai and Jagannath Bhagwan deity also, so we can have darshan of them, Jagannath also. So you can see this very old structure, a very old temple, and traditional Bengali temple structure where Prabhupada used to come in the childhood and worship daily Radha Govinda temple. And this temple, in this deity, we have Radha Govinda deities, and this temple is maintained by whole Malik Parivar, not individually by Prabhupada. All used to family combine and used to maintain this temple. So this temple is maintained by Prabhupada family. So we can have darshan there of the Lordship. now we can see that after Bhoga, the temple will be opened.